Kai, lovely to have your company. The Reserve Bank is meeting for the first time this year today, with Australians told to brace for what is expected to be the ninth hike in a row for interest rates. 10 News First journalist Ursula Heger joins us on the desk. Ursula, it's so great to have you with us. What does this mean for mortgage holders?
Well, essentially, Narelda, a whole lot more pain. The Reserve Bank is expected to lift the official cash rate at 2.30 for the ninth time, with most economists anticipating it will be a 25 basis hike, bringing that official rate to 3.35%. What that means is another $114 for the average mortgage of around $750,000, $150 more a month for a $1 million loan. That doesn't sound too difficult, but the problem here is the cumulative impact of those hikes. Since May last year, those on the average mortgage are paying $1,300 more a month for a $1 million loan. Certainly very popular here in Sydney, they have to find an extra $1,800 a month. What the RBA is doing here is essentially trying to control our spending to reduce the rate of inflation. And while we have seen retail figures drop slightly in December, most economists say that's either a data blip or not enough to have an impact on the Reserve Bank thinking. So where to from here? Well, that depends on who you talk to. Deutsche Bank's senior economist thinks that we will have as many as 4 rate rises this year, including this one. Others, including the Commonwealth Bank, think after this one, the Reserve Bank will hold off and have a look at the impact of these consecutive rate rises on the economy.
It is now landing a punch on many family budgets. It's starting to show up in the data, particularly the retail trades data. That's exactly what the RBA wants. They want to see us spending less at the shops so that demand goes down and hopefully prices stop surging.
Well, but that impact is already being felt on property values. According to PropTrack, they're expecting a fall between 7 and 10% across the country this year after an average fall of 2.3% last year. The worst hit will be Sydney, Brisbane and Melbourne, while Adelaide and Perth will drop, but by a little less. Narelda?
I don't know, a drop in property prices, that just causes more problems for people who have taken out mortgages because their house will be valued
exactly
more than what they're repaying.
A whole lot less.
It's a bit of a nightmare. And also $1,800 an extra a month, $1 million for a lot of people outside of Sydney or Melbourne, it sounds like a lot, but that's just the average price of a home here.
Yes, well, I never forget that the Reserve Bank did say that they weren't going to do this for a long time, so people got frightened. They entered the property market at those massive rates because they essentially thought that they had to, otherwise they'd just miss out. The fear of missing out means now a lot of people have huge mortgages and they can't repay them.
Thank you very much for updating us. We'll be watching closely the RBA's decision at 2.30 this afternoon, Eastern Time.